G'day, Dave here, and we're looking at Psalm 23. This is probably the most famous and familiar of all of the Psalms. It's a particularly precious Psalm, I know, to so many people. The words are powerful, they're poignant, and yet they're gentle and they're comforting. And this is a Psalm we hear at funerals, we hear read at the bedside of those who are dying. And it's a Psalm that I think has simply been appropriated by Christians right down through the centuries. And it's easy, isn't it, to insert ourselves into this psalm to say the Lord is my shepherd. He's Dave's shepherd. He's your shepherd. He leads us. He refreshes us. He guides us. And to insert ourselves into the psalm to find comfort from these words. Well, if you've been following me through this series and you've been exploring these psalms, you might be worried that I'm going to take this approach away from you. To say, hang on, the best thing to do is not simply to insert yourself into this psalm. And you might be thinking, don't dare do that. This psalm is just too important to me. I don't want to lose this psalm. It's very, very precious to me. It's special. I treasure this psalm. Well, I want to say to you, I'm not going to take it away, but I want to explore with you how to read it well. Because I think as we pay greater effort to understanding this psalm in its context, to read it well, then it will give us greater comfort and greater hope and a real joy in knowing that this psalm actually points us to a great hope that you and I can take hold of. Now, let's look at it in its context. And once again, we see that it's a psalm of David. It's there in the inscription. It's a song of the king. And ultimately, I think this is a psalm by David about Christ written for Christians. And we'll see that, I think. It's a song by David about Christ written for Christians. Now, let's read it first of all. The Lord is my shepherd, I lack nothing. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. He refreshes my soul. He guides me along the right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows. Surely your goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. It's a beautiful psalm, isn't it? Well, David, who wrote this psalm, knew what it was to be a shepherd. You can read the accounts of his early life. He was the youngest of many brothers, and he was the shepherd of the sheep. While the brothers went off and fought in wars and so on, David's responsibility was to take care of the sheep. And God had a plan for David that involved him eventually becoming the king of Israel. And the shepherd is an image to help us to understand the king as well. So David becomes, as king, a shepherd to his people Israel. He takes care of them, he guides them, he protects them, he makes sure that they have what they need. God entrusts his people to the shepherd David. Now, David, as a shepherd, as he writes this psalm, is also a sheep. The shepherd is a sheep. So David, as sheep, looks to the Lord as his shepherd. And the word for Lord here, we've got the capital L-O-R-D. It's actually a reference to the name of God, Yahweh, or however it was to be pronounced. It's a relationship word for God. He is my God, David is saying. And this God cares for David. He protects him, he guides him, he strengthens him, so that David can lead and bless and provide for his people. You see, God cares for his people Israel by providing for the king who provides for the people. And that's a key thing that we'll see going on as you look at the life of David. It's what's supposed to happen with the Davidic kings that follow after him. But David is not only a sheep and a shepherd. The scriptures tell us that David is also a prophet. That is, he speaks God's word. And that's what we've got here in the Psalms. David takes God's word by the Spirit and he writes it, he speaks it, he communicates it. And David is pointing forward, his life and his words are pointing forward. The Psalm, even Psalm 23, is pointing forward to the Christ. Now, we saw that very explicitly in Psalm 22. If you didn't have a chance to listen to Psalm 22 and go over that talk, I do encourage you to go back and look at Psalm 22, because the connections to Jesus are just inescapable. But just as they apply in Psalm 22, so also I take it they apply in Psalm 23. The Gospels help us to see Jesus fulfilling Psalm 23. First of all, Jesus is the Lamb of God. He's described in the Gospels as the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. But not only is he the Lamb of God, he is the one who needs to trust God as he goes through the darkest valley. And so if you look at verse 4, even though I walk through the darkest valley, I will fear no evil, for you are with me, your rod and your staff, they comfort me. How appropriate that Jesus might have prayed these words in the Garden of Gethsemane as he approaches the darkest event in all of human history, his own execution on a cross where he takes God's wrath upon us. See, here is a promise to Jesus that he can trust in the Lord who is his shepherd. And God answers the prayer, doesn't he? He restores Jesus' life and soul. He makes Jesus the anointed king for all eternity. Jesus has a banqueting table with his loved ones in the presence of his enemies who've been overthrown. See, God answers Jesus' prayer. And like David, Jesus is not only the sheep, but he's also the shepherd. So God rules over his people. He provides comfort and care and protection and guidance for his people by the shepherd, who is Jesus. 1 Peter chapter 5 describes Jesus as the chief shepherd. John chapter 10 describes Jesus as the good shepherd. Let me read to you these words from John chapter 10. Jesus says, "I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep." Verse 14, "I am the good shepherd. I know my sheep and my sheep know me. Just as the Father knows me and I know the Father, and I lay down my life for the sheep." Or jumping down a bit further to verse 27, "My sheep listen to my voice. I know them and they follow me. I give them eternal life and they shall never perish. No one can snatch them out of my hand." And he goes on in verse 30 to say, "I and the Father are one." You see, the Lord is my shepherd. Yes, Jesus is my shepherd. Well, how can we have Jesus as our shepherd? Well, I think the answer is here. "My sheep listen to my voice and I know them and they follow me." You see, if we listen to Jesus' voice and we follow him, then we can know Jesus as our shepherd. We can know God as our shepherd. You see, the way into finding comfort and hope and real life for all eternity in Psalm 23 is to listen to Jesus and to follow him. See, this isn't a psalm for any random who wants to just mouth the words. This isn't just like a card, a Hallmark card that brings comfort to people in tough times. It's not a mantra that can be kind of recited to make us feel better about ourselves. This is a genuine promise to all who will come before God, come before his good shepherd Jesus, and listen to him and follow him, that he will look after us. It's a great promise. But friends, we need to hear his voice and to follow him. That's what this psalm is calling us to do, to hear Jesus' voice and to come to him. And that's where real hope, real comfort, real direction, real life, real eternity is to be found. And I want to pause at this time just to ask you, have you come to Jesus? Have you listened to his voice and are you following him? Jesus is calling you to follow. He's calling you to put your trust in him. He is the good shepherd who laid down his life for you. He paid the price on the cross for your rebellion against God. He's taking your place. He's your substitute. He's the good shepherd laying down his life to protect the sheep. Will you trust in Jesus? Will you hear his voice and listen to him? And will you keep listening to his voice? And will you keep following him? Because if you do, then Psalm 23 is your promise. It's a great promise. Friends, you might be going through a dark valley at this moment. You may be struggling with all kinds of serious things in your life. Maybe you're feeling depressed, down. Life is a struggle. Maybe you or a member of your family has a serious illness and you're struggling to know what the future holds. Maybe this whole COVID thing has just got you so down and so fearful and so anxious and so housebound that you don't know where to turn. Maybe you've lost your job and you're wondering what the future holds. Friends, maybe you're just struggling to find meaning and purpose and hope and a future in life. Well, turn to the Good Shepherd. Turn to Jesus. Listen to him. Follow him. Psalm 23 reminds us that God is committed to us so much that Jesus, the Good Shepherd, would lay down his life for you and for me. Will we listen to him? Will we follow him?